In today's lesson, we will see how we can use so-called discount factors to value a government bond. I'll show you a process called bootstrapping, which helps us to work out these discount factors for market prices. From the discount factors, we will work out zero coupon rates. Finally, we'll plot these rates and bond yields in the form of a yield curve. Imagine you're looking at a government bond with a 3-year maturity that pays an annual coupon of 6%. How would you determine its fair value? Well, as we've discussed in previous lessons, the value of any asset is the present value of its future cash flows. The cash flows of this 3-year 6% coupon bond are: year 1, coupon payment of 6, year 2, again a coupon payment of 6, year 3, the same coupon payment and the principal repayment of 100%, so 106 in total. So the value of the bond is the sum of the present values of these cash flows. As we saw in our lesson on time value of money, see the link above if you missed it, the formula for present value is PV, present value, equals cash flow divided by 1 plus R to the power of T, where R is the annual discount rate and T is the number of years. To make the workings much easier in what follows, we will use the concept of a discount factor, which is defined for a certain time to maturity as DF of T equals 1 over 1 plus R to the power of T. With this definition of the discount factor, the PV formula becomes simply PV equals cash flow times discount factor. In our example of a 3-year bond with a 6% coupon, the PV in terms of discount factors is then PV equals 6 times DF1 plus 6 times DF2 plus 106 times DF3. So, to value our bond, we need to know these discount factors for 1, 2, and 3 years. Unfortunately, we don't always have directly observable zero coupon bonds trading in the market for all the maturities we need to work this out. However, what we do see are government bonds with various maturities, coupon rates, and trading prices. The key insight is that we can use the information from these traded coupon-bearing bonds to work out the discount factors for different maturities. The technique we use to do this is called bootstrapping. Let's see how this works with a simplified example using 3 hypothetical government bonds with annual coupons and maturities of 1 to 3 years, all trading at par, which means a price of 100. Here are the bonds we'll be working with. Now, let's see how we can use this information to work out the discount factors for each maturity. We'll essentially work our way up from the shortest maturity. Please note that I've attached a spreadsheet with details of all the calculations from this lesson. Year 1. Using the simplified PV formula with the discount factor, PV equals cash flow times DF1. PV is the price of the bond, so we have 100 equals the cash flow after 1 year for this bond, which is a coupon of 4 plus the repayment of principal of 100. So 104 times the discount factor for cash flows in year 1, which is DF1. So 100 equals 104 times DF1. Hence, DF1 equals 100 divided by 104 equals 0.9615. So we have our first discount factor. Now, let's consider the 2-year bond with a 4.5% annual coupon. Pays 4.5% in year 1, 104.5% coupon plus principal in year 2. Price of this bond, again 100, must be the present value of these cash flows multiplied by the appropriate discount factors. So we can set up the equation again. 100 equals 4.5 times DF1 plus 104.5 times DF2. We already know the 1-year discount factor, so we can substitute this in. And we can rearrange and solve for DF2, the discount factor for year 2, we get 0.9155. And then for the 3-year bond, with the 4.75% coupon, we can set up the equation in a similar way. Substitute in the values for DF1 and DF2, and solve for DF3. Which gives 0.8695. So, now that we've used this bootstrapping process to derive the annual discount factors for the first 3 years, let's go back to the question we started with. What is the fair value of a 3-year government bond that pays an annual coupon of 6%? Using the discount factors we calculated, the value of the bond 6 times discount factor 1 plus 6 times discount factor 2 plus 106 times discount factor 3. which adds up to 103.43. Note that in the spreadsheet, I've also added hypothetical bonds with 4 and 5 year maturities and continued the calculations, but this is not necessary to value our 3 year bond. To simplify our calculations, we use discount factors for each maturity rather than interest rates. But for completeness, let's see what the discount rates are for 1 to 5 years. To calculate this, we can start with the formula for the discount factor. We solve for R, we get R equals 1 over the discount factor, all to the power of 1 over T, minus 1. This gives the discount rates shown in the table. And finally, I want to talk briefly about yield curves. Simply put, a yield curve is a graph that shows the relationship between the yield and the time to maturity for bonds of the same credit quality or issuer, in our case, government bonds. In our example, we know both the zero coupon yields and the yields of the coupon paying bonds that we use as inputs. So I've plotted both of them here. The bond yields are effectively weighted averages of the zero coupon yields. Note that in our simplified example with all bonds trading at par, the yield to maturity is in each case the same as the coupon. We will go into this in more detail and we'll see more complex examples in the next lesson. In conclusion, we've seen how to use the bootstrapping method to calculate discount factors and construct a zero coupon yield curve from the prices and coupons of government bonds. We can then use these discount factors to value other cash flows and bonds consistently with the market. While our example was simplified, the underlying principles are fundamental to fixed income valuation. In the next lesson, we'll take a more detailed look at bond valuation with some more complex examples than we saw today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.